Hello again. I'm Carlos. This is Bonsai-YEAH. Today, we're going to repot my Calliandra, also known as a powder puff. It's known as a powder puff because it will put out these little balls that look like, you got it, powder puffs. I've yet to have any one of my Calliandras do that yet. But this is a new one to the dish, to my family, to my bonsai family here. That would be the front of it there. Well, today, I want to get it out of this soil it's in, and I want to get it into some bonsai soil. And you'll see I've put wire, and I've shaped up this tree. Now, normally, a Calliandra wants to grow out, not up. So I'm encouraging the main branches to grow up by putting some heavy gauge aluminum wire, and then I wrap it around and I contort the branches. Isn't that neat? You can make it look very unusual. You can make it look as natural as you want. I think it's fun to do this, but after a couple months, you have to be careful. You don't want it to bite into the bark. What's happening is that it's growing underneath, thickening up. And when the wire, it's not going to bend along with it, so it's just going to grow over it. You've seen it happen to gates. You've seen it to all sorts of things where trees are growing next to something. The tree will take over. So we have to be careful that we don't leave any wire scars. So I think these have been on here long enough where I'm going to cut them off. We're going to prune this down a bit, and then we're going to repot this and use bonsai soil. All right, let's just get started here. So the first thing I wanna get to doing is getting all this wire off, at least the smaller ones. I think this thicker wire is doing okay. It's somewhat loosely wrapped around, giving it still some structure. We'll cut one of them off and see where everything's going, but one at a time. The easiest way to do this is cut at each little node, and what I have here is my wire cutter here, flat. Makes it easy to get right up against the wire and snip it without hurting the branch whatsoever. It's saved me a lot, and the way I thought that you had to do this was you come by and literally unwrap the whole, oh my goodness. I tell you, that is not the way anybody wants to have to do that. You have to try to work around all the branches without knocking off any of the leaves. It's just a pain. As soon as I got this wire cutter, game changer, y'all. So we're going along. Yeah, I can start seeing, I can see that it's starting to bite down ever so slightly. As you can see, it's starting to creep in. And I got it just in time that it's not completely digging in, because those scars don't go away very easily, and they'll be there for a very long time if they go away at all. We're catching it early, which is great. And the wiring is, it's not too pretty. So it's also great to get this off and see if it's gonna hold its shape. So far, so good. I think it's been here long enough where it's developed a memory for it. I don't know quite what makes it do that. Oh yeah, so I'm cutting some of this and I can see that it's starting to spring back, and that's okay. We encourage it to grow in somewhat of a natural way. It's not, there were a lot of unnatural bends in it, I think, but I think now it's springing to a natural resting point. What kind of trees do you have at your place? Do you keep any trees? You could email us. You can show us your trees. We'll have the email address right there on the screen there for you. And as I continue to remove the wire, we're just about done with the thin wire. That one's really starting to bite in there. And that's where it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen more in these more extreme turns, and let me get you a view of that Now that's starting to bite in a lot more. You see that? That's really starting to bite in right there. No bueno, huh? It's okay. It's not too bad. Hopefully it'll bounce back from that. But that was a nice, that was a big turn, a big twist that I had in there. And that's what you got to also be careful if you're wiring. We'll do wiring in a future episode as well. It's not really time for me to be doing wiring. It's really not the greatest season to be repotting either. But these are trees that will be, these are evergreen trees. They're tropical, so they don't live in this environment where I'm in here in zone 8B. So that means it gets to freezing temperature, doesn't necessarily snow. Although February here, we had a killer like week long winter storm. The likes no family in Texas has ever seen, I'd say, at least in Austin and in the area, surrounding area. I've seen a little bit of snow out here, maybe snow for a couple hours, but for 5 days, 7 days straight, you'd stay inside. Woo boy. It's a good thing we were stocked up on puzzles from the coronavirus before that, huh? So plenty to do, plenty to see. And the, what I was getting at there is that my plants were suffering, you know, in the garage. I'm trying to keep them warm, burning some leaves because I got it too warm from the heater. There's a lot of nightmares that happened, and I lost a lot of my plants, but I learned an awful lot about keeping them inside for the season. And then we're talking about the tropicals, but even a lot of the ones that I can keep outside year long, I end up dying because of the very harsh weather that we had, which none of us anticipated. So we're all ready for it this time. Bring it on. I've got more of a insight on how to keep these nice and warm in the garage alone. We're gonna have an easy winter. Across my fingers, across my branches. Okay, so I've got most of the wires off. I'm keeping the bigger ones on here for now. I think it's just, I need that for the structure of that big branch. Figure out where I need it to go. And maybe I'll come back in a month or two and snip off that wire. But you know what, it's so close to biting in. I may just have to opt to go for it now, but I don't think I've got the courage right now, ladies and gentlemen. So we're gonna get into repotting. And one thing we're gonna do, and I'm also going to assess the root mass, the root ball. We're gonna see the surface roots here, see if they're worth spreading out. We want a nice radial base. We wanna think about the future development for this, and we don't want it in a big pot. Eventually we want a smaller pot. And just to make this look gigantic, it looks like a giant tree in a way. So you want it to grow out instead of down, left and right versus down. So we're going to cut off any tap roots, any sort of roots that are pointing down. Thank you. going to get right into this, and we're going to comb it out using a little rake fork here, fork rake. Check in the bottom, make sure it's not being held in. And we're just going to pop it right out and see how the roots are doing. Look at that. Oh boy. It's looking good, healthy, a lot of roots. It's not quite getting to the point where it's wrapping around the bowl yet, the pot, which is good. So I'm starting off by taking the surface roots and just, we're going to gently comb everything out. We're gonna try not to disturb the roots too much. In this process, we are gonna be taking down some of the roots here. Matter of fact, before we get into any of that, I'm getting way ahead of myself. I wanna try to reduce down some of this foliage because we're gonna be messing with the roots, right? If we mess with the roots, we've got to do the equal amount to the foliage. That's what's supporting each other. It's symbiosis there. It's the yin and the yang. So if we're going to take this down, I think we need to do a little bit of pruning here first. It's just going to be the safe thing to do. Okay, so let's take a look at what we have here. It's looking great. We're just going to clip a lot of the newer shoots and some of the more sprawling out branches. I think I like this one. It's a tough thing, but I can tell you there's a few things right off the bat I want to get rid of, and it's going to be this branch right here. He comes in and then towards the back. He should be trying to go in out. He should be trying to go out towards the front there, and we're going to find a little node to cut, and where we are, we're right here, right? Okay. All right. There he is right here, there he is. I just wanna get rid of him real quick. And I'm finding a leaf that sticks out this way, away from the tree, and I'm gonna cut about halfway through, anticipating any dieback there. I've had very little success with the clippings turning into cuttings, rather. It's not so great for me yet, but I keep trying, so keep persevering. We showed you last week how to clone. I've tried it with this. It's just maybe I do it in the wrong time of year. All right, so I'm clipping off any of the dead branches that didn't survive the last round of defoliation this had. I don't remember when it had it. It was a couple months ago. And it's back when I first wired it. So we got this long guy right here just saying hello. And I think he's just a little crowded here. There you go with that tip right there. You know, and I just don't care for that branch at all. I'm going for it. Say goodbye to that branch. Goodbye. Neater. And so what I think I'll do is I'll take a little bit of this wire, get around that branch. There we go. Now I can sort of contort where I want that to go. It's a little better. Actually, I want it to go up a little. That needs, you can just contort it. That's looking good. I like the profile. This guy's a little too much here. I think we'll go ahead and cut it down to there. Also, I've got one right here. A little sticks out a little too much there. A little one that sticks out a little too much. We're going to go a little quicker here because I want to get to the repotting. We are taking off some foliage. So it's a good idea to go around and just, you know, take off the, if it's got more than two or three, I said three leaf nodes, it's okay to cut it. If it's got one or two, I'd hold off. But if it's got this many, you just go ahead and you can snip that off. There should be, it's got a lot of energy that's trying to flow to that tip, and that's going to be diverted right into one of those nodes where it's going to turn into another branch. Bifurcate. So, okay, I think we're in a good spot here. And that one kind of goes up and in towards the tree. And then get rid of this one too. It's got one, two nodes. I hold off on that one. Okay. I think we're good for now. I think that's a good pruning. Maybe it looks a little heavy right here. I think, yeah, I think you're right. I know you guys were saying there, you were going, Los, I think that's a little heavy right there. You can stand to take that down. And you know what? I got it. You guys are right. So you're saying the same, saying the same thing over here? Really? I did miss it. You're right. Yep, you're right. Well, what would I do without you guys? Okay, I think that looks wonderful. Enough to continue on with our repotting. So we've taken a good 10% off the top there. Right into the compost that goes. Okay, so we're gonna go back to the repotting here, which now we are safe to do so. Now I'm just combing this root surface here, and I want to see if there's any big, fatter roots that are spreading out radially. Okay, we don't want them to go down, we want them to spread out. Like you've seen, like those trees with the great big buttresses. If you think about the big redwood trees, or even those old cypresses in Louisiana, or even right down in the river, if you're going to San Marcos there, just right down the river, those giant trees with the giant buttresses. Okay, Los, take it easy. Okay. All right. So it's got a pretty decent looking root base here. Got a lot of roots growing downwards, so we're gonna have to try to correct those. We may be able to salvage them to get them to become straighter there. You see, we're getting wonderful root flare. And think about that, that little tiny root, that's gonna grow up and be a nice fat root just like this, because that's how that started off, just time. So we've got some crisscrossy roots that we gotta deal with. But I gotta get all this organic soil out of here. Yeah, and normally this is the kind of soil that you'd see, you'd put in if you're just a normal household gardener, you've planted some tomatoes, you know, the old garden soil. It's just dirt, right? Bonsai soil isn't that. And you'll be just surprised to know that you don't need organics in there. You'd like to have maybe a little bit, and we're gonna be using a soil that does have some organics in it. But I discovered along the journey of bonsai, it's like basically rock. You're gonna look at it and go, this is just like rocks, lavas and pumice and clay. It's a bit weird, but I'll explain to you why. So I've got the bottom of the root ball here, and I'm gonna just gently start from the middle and work my way out. This particular soil here is very heavy on the pine bark. Or just bark. I don't know if it's pine, but it's definitely bark. It's like pine bark. You know, that rocky looking stuff from a very old pine tree shedding off his outer layer of skin there. Show off his new stuff he's grown inside. Now, if I was at my garden, I'd take this into one of my barrels of water and just rinse this out till I saw nothing but roots. And that way you can deal with the roots a lot easier. In this instance, I'm going to leave a little bit of the soil. You want to leave a little bit of soil on its first transplant out because, listen, this is its old home. You got to take a little bit with you. You know, you got something, if they're going to take you, think about it. They pick you up and put you in a new home. at least you'd want a little something, right? You'd want, bring me back, can I keep at least the TV? You know, can I keep the Chromecast or something? You know, let me keep a book or something. So we're gonna let him keep a few books. We're gonna let him keep a few bucks there. Are you one of those type that name your bonsais? I'm not. There's too many. I'm constantly on the lookout for new plants. I go to any place that, like a Home Depot or a Lowe's. If I'm there, I gotta walk through the garden and see if there's at least a shrub or something, a boxwood, a juniper that needs to get out of there and become a bonsai, because it's gonna have a great life there. You know, you get a lot of water, you get a lot of food, you know, you get fed, and you know, there's someone always taking care of you. All right, so I think we're looking pretty good. That's a pretty fair root base. You know what? I'm still going to keep going to the bottom here because it's pretty matted up down here. And I just want to spread out this root base here. I don't want it downwards. I want it outwards. Just like the way it wants to grow in the wild is the way I want the roots to go. It's a messy process, y'all. So it's got all these little green balls in it. You ever wonder what those little green balls are, y'all? So they're very slow-release fertilizer, which I don't like. Get those out of there. And there's a reason why we use bonsai soil, and it has something to do with our fertilizer. So let's try to get as much of that out of our root ball. Whew. Oh, boy.
It's a lot of raking.
Okay. Okay, great. So, just doing a lot of that raking. Remove some roots, which is absolutely fine. There's plenty of roots in there. These are very healthy roots. These are super healthy roots. They're doing amazing. They are loving life in this soil. I worry about overwatering in the greenhouse. It's a pretty moist environment in there. Humid, and I want to be careful we don't overwater this. And most of my trees have that bonsai soil already, so I want to make sure they're all living the same type of life, living the same truth. And I'm really trying to get in there, and maybe you can get camera two on here. See, I'm just trying to get that root mass, separate some of these roots here, get a good look at what we're looking at here. Good look at what we're looking at. And that's the soil I'm gonna keep. I'm just gonna aerate it a bit. The soil that's right in the middle of the root ball, the heart of the matter. It's really not the heart because the feeder roots are like the stuff that are on the outside. That's what's out there feeding the tree. The other ones are just kicking back and multi-level marketing this kind of thing. Okay, let's spread out that root ball some more. This metal chopstick really does really well. It's in every bonsai practitioner's toolbox, a chopstick, whether it be made of bamboo or made out of metal. Chopstick is gonna work wonderfully. It's not as harsh as some of the rakes that have that angle to them that will just, once you try to pull it through some roots, it just yanks everything out. This actually guides it through pretty easily. All right, so I think I've pulled enough of this out. I'm gonna spread out the mass of tree here, this root mass here. Spread it out in a radial fashion here. Oh, we're going to cut off no more than 10% of this roots, of these roots. All right, working on the clock here. So I'm gonna put it in this trainer pot to get it started, and I'm gonna try to find the front, which I believe is right about there, and I'm gonna face it towards me. and I want to place it in the pot. Now, I don't place the trunk right in the middle of everything. It's right in the middle, but then I take it a little bit back. As you can see, it sort of comes out and it's more heavier right here. It sort of leads to a more balanced tree, don't you think? I think you're right. All right, so I'm gonna use some bonsai soil. Why do we use bonsai soil? Now, this particular bonsai soil is pumice, clay, black lava, and pine bark fines. Now, this is a very great mix made by the folks at We Are the Bonsai Supply, Jerome. Great bonsai practitioner. Hope to one day meet. Now, you could wire this down into the pot if you want by bringing up a couple wires through the drainage holes. I'm gonna place that right there. Yeah, I think it looks good. Cut off any of these ones that are growing up. Make sure they're all pointing down. And we're just going to drop a bunch of soil in here. We want it to get in between the roots. Give it a little shakeroo. This is the important part right here. You take your chopstick, just go poking around. Poke, poke, poke. You poke and you try to fill in the hole. Poke, fill in the hole, poke, fill in the hole. And this is just ensuring that there's no big giant air gaps, which will dry out your root ball. Now the next thing to do is to water this very thoroughly and then get it in the shade and let it recover. Well, thank you guys very much for joining us once again. Bonsai-YEAH. If you like our content, keep watching. The email address is down on the screen now. We'll see you guys next week. Be cool. Stay hip. Get yourself a hobby. Bye.